Hello students, in the previous session we have seen the way of converting an analog signal into a digital signal through sampling and quantization process. So now we'll see the way of representing discrete time sequences. So for that you need to consider an analog signal, any analog signal you can consider. I have considered a cosine waveform. So its expression is x of t equal to a cos 2 pi f into t. F is the sampling frequency or frequency of the signal x of t. If that signal is sampled at a sampling interval, say capital T, where T is known as a sampling rate, we'll get a discrete time sequences, that is x of n t, whose expression is a into cos 2 pi f n t, where T is the sampling interval, f is the frequency, n is the variable whose name value changes from 0, 1, 2 and so on. For simplicity, we can denote the sequence x of n t as x of n, because here only n is the variable, t is the fixed time interval. Since t is fixed, we can ignore that t and we can denote the discrete time sequence as x of n. So we can rewrite that x of n t expression as x of n equal to a cos 2 pi f n t. So as we know, the sampling rate t is indirectly proportional to the sampling frequency, that is fs equal to 1 by t. We can replace the t sampling rate by 1 by fs. So that we'll get the expression for discrete time sequence as a into cos 2 pi fn by fs. So we have an expression for digital frequency theta, which is equal to 2 pi f into capital T. So we can replace the capital 2 pi f as theta. So the discrete time sequences will be a into cos theta n. So theta will have a unit radians. After conversion, that x of n sequence is known as a sinusoidal sequence. So to find the discrete time sequence, we need to sample an analog signal, say x of t, at some sampling interval capital T to obtain a digital sequence x of n. So next we'll see the way of transforming a time domain signal into a frequency domain signals. That can be done through Fourier transform. There are two types of Fourier transform. One is discrete Fourier transform and fast Fourier transform. So you can see the expression for DFT, that is x of k equal to summation small n equal to 0 to capital N minus 1 x of n e power minus j 2 pi nk divided by n, where n is the number of samples, x of n is the discrete time sequence, x of k is the DFT signal, frequency domain sequence x of k. X of n and x of k are known as DFT pairs, discrete Fourier transform pair. You can get the time sequence, that is x of n, from the discrete Fourier transform value, frequency domain value, that is x of k, using the second equation, that is x of n equal to 1 by n summation k equal to 0 capital N minus 1 x of k e power j 2 pi nk by n. So these are the two ways of converting, or you can say transforming, a time domain sequence, that is x of n, into a frequency domain sequence, that is x of k. So using DFT, you can find endpoint sequences. But if you observe this expression, we are performing product and then we are adding those products. So as number of samples increases, as n increases, the number of products obtained increases, which in turn increases number of additions. So the complexity of multiplication and complexity of addition keeps on increasing as n increases. So it leads to a complexity of hardware and complexity of computation. To reduce that, to avoid that, we'll go for fast Fourier transform method. So through a fast Fourier transform method, you can convert a time domain sequence x of n with n points into a frequency domain sequence. So in fast Fourier transform, we are dividing n samples, n points into n by 2 points, next n by 2 points into n by 4 points, and so on till we get minimum 2 points. Next we'll compute a 2 point DFT using the DFT expression, and then we'll combine to obtain the Fourier transform. That method is known as fast Fourier transform. There are two algorithms. One is known as decimation and time FFT, and decimation and frequency FFT. So using these two methods, one is DFT and FFT, you can convert any time domain sequence into a frequency domain sequence. So in this session, we have seen the way of representing a discrete time sequence and the way of converting a discrete time sequence in a time domain to a frequency domain sequence. In the next class, we'll see the characteristics of a linear time system. Thank you. Happy learning.